YouTube channel.
You're welcome. You're welcome. Mm-hmm. We're excited to see you.
Yes. So you are.
So today we're going to be talking about five things every serious guy needs to know while dating. Very long topic, but the name is long. The topic too is long.
Yes.
So I'll give you a disclaimer before we go ahead that today's discussion is going to be lengthy, but then it's for your own good.
We want to do justice.
Yeah, to the subject.
To everything. So you are.
My name is Tekin the Teaser.
And I'm Faith Teaser. And together we are the Teasers.
Yes.
So let's get back.
So straight into the topic of discussion. Five things every guy.
Every serious guy.
Yeah, every serious guy. And this is for serious guys. It's not for somebody that is a player or wants to just, you know, hanky-panky. Five things every serious guy needs to know about maintaining a relationship or while dating. Any one of them you choose to title it, you know. A lot of relationships fail today because some people miss certain things. Now, this is a guy's edition. I believe that a ladies edition will come out soon, so watch out for this channel. So let's go straight into it since we have a lot to talk about. The first thing every guy needs to know and needs to do is this: you must establish territory. You must establish territory. Now, don't be in a hurry to conclude, you know what I'm trying to say, but just listen. You must establish territory. What does it mean? Everyone must discern, or everyone that comes around your babe must be able to discern that somebody exists in her life.
Yeah.
People must be able to tell that you are a serious guy. Listen, even dogs do this. You know, when a dog is in a place, in a compound or around the vicinity, what they do is that they pee around that vicinity to tell other dogs that I'm a dog living here.
A dog lives here.
Yes. The interesting thing is this. Even lions do it too. What they do is when their kids grow, when their cubs grow into big lions, they send them away to go and look for territories for themselves.
Yeah.
You can't be staying with me because you come and defeat me and become king. That's what happens.
Yeah.
They kill their fathers and become king.
Yeah, so their mothers.
Yeah, so the king, what he does is to establish his territory before they are strong enough, he sends them away to establish his territory. So it's a biological, it's a trait that we have as human beings. And if you fail to do that, you will lose out.
Yeah.
So the wise thing you can do is establish territory.
Yes.
You know, so that you can make everyone know that
a man is here.
A man is here.
Mm.
Listen, I heard this a couple of times from two or three different elderly people, and it is true. Do you know that your brother or your friends, the one thing about your brother or your friends is this: you guys most times have things in common. And one of those things you have in common the most is the kinds of people you are attracted to.
That's true.
So because they are your friends, they will like what you like most times.
Wisdom. Yes. Wisdom.
That's my only problem. And because they are your siblings, guys now, they will like what you like.
That's true.
The probability is higher than for you guys to be opposite. Yeah. The probability to like the same things. It's higher, especially for friends.
Yeah.
And today, because the world is evil, people do not care.
Mm-hmm.
Somebody will come and chance you.
Yes.
You know, so establish that territory. Mm. Be conscious of it. Mm-hmm. And what are the simple ways to establish territories?
Mm.
You know, we'll just go straight to it. I've said this before. Listen, we're going to work on a short book concerning this particular subject.
Yeah.
So we can be more detailed. But this video, you know, even if it is long, it cannot be too long, so you don't, you know, exhaust your data and then you don't stay too long listening. So one way you can establish territory is,
all right, one way to establish territory is to establish a line of communication. This is very important. Now, as a guy, you cannot be, if you are not in a secret affair, if you are not doing secret affair, there must be somebody that knows that, okay, you exist, and then you must know somebody among her friends. Her friends must know you. Her family members have to know you. You have to have a good communication and a good rapport with at least her friends, her family. It is very important. Because guess what? There are times when you need someone to talk to her. It is those people that will be the ones to help you out. And then because those people know that you exist, when another guy is coming, they are standing up for you. Somehow, unconsciously. Do you understand what I'm saying? So it's important for you to establish a line of communication. Let me give you a brief example. Like when my husband was planning my proposal, because he knew my friends, he knew my family, was able to plan with them. So everybody worked together to make it so beautiful. That's why it's important for you to establish a line of communication. Very, very, very important.
Yeah, and you know, even if it's just one friend,
yes,
it mustn't be all the friends, mm-hmm, or all the family members, because yeah, I don't think everybody will like you at the first instance. So probably like, no, I don't think like that though. But probably even if it's one person, one, yeah, friend, one, because some people do not have the this thing to be friends with everybody.
Yeah.
And you don't go and be friends with everybody, then they start confusing. But yes, at least make an attempt.
Yes.
You know, to be friends with someone. Then the next thing I'm going to say is, you know, especially for you, a believer, pray for her. Pray for her. Pray for her. Listen, let me tell you a secret about walking, especially in the kingdom of God and the workings of the earth. Everything in this earth is territorial. There is a contest for territory. So angels are established to maintain territory for the gospel, and demons are established at positions, to establish territories around. So when you pray for a person, so what we pastors do, I mean, pastors, I'm telling the truth, you pray for a territory, you pray for a place. Mm. When you pray for that place, you are establishing, how do I put it now?
A mark of ownership.
Exactly, in that place. Mm. So that any power that comes knows that, okay, there's an edge here.
Yes.
There's a edge here.
Yes.
So when you pray over the person you're dating, it's not wait till you're married. When you pray over her, there is that territorial hedge over her. Mm. Hedge over her. Mm. I'm telling you, it works. Yeah. There is that territorial hedge over her. Let me give you a practical example of a situation like this, where there was even if it was a spiritual thing, even if it was physical relationship, there was a spiritual interference.
Yes.
Abraham, when Abimelech wanted to take his wife, if I'm not when he wanted to, when he took his wife,
Sarah,
his wife, guess what? In the night, the Lord came to him. He said, Abimelech, you're a dead man.
Dead, though.
In this day, you are dying. No. As long as I'll kill you, so you're a dead man. He said, you took a prophet's wife.
Ah.
And then the guy said, sir, I didn't know. Yeah. The guy told me. Can you imagine? Abraham even lied that it was his sister. You know, but God understood that it was because he was scared. And in those days, people were ruthless. They could kill you for the slightest reasons.
Mm.
So he didn't want to lose his life. And he said, it's his sister. And Abimelech took her, but he didn't sleep with her.
Yeah.
And God said, I was the one that made you not to sleep with her. Can you imagine? So you see, there is a spiritual implication for every relationship.
That's true.
And so God said, go and return the wife. Not only return her, let him pray for you.
Yes. Exactly.
So it's important, pray for her.
Yeah.
You create that hedge over her.
Yes.
Yes.
All right, so another thing is that you have to be present.
Yes.
We have said it before that people can cast dating shadows.
Yes.
And what we said in that video, we said sometimes even when you're not dating the person, but because the person is always around,
yeah,
people get the vibe like, oh, you're dating somebody, there's somebody around.
Yes.
That's what you do when you are serious about a lady.
Yes.
You will always be there. Oh my God. My husband is a perfect example for this. When we're dating, I tell people, if we do not see in 365 days, maybe it's just 10 times, 10 days. So just assume it's 355 days. You must be present. You must be there. People must know that this, we're not saying stalk her.
Yes.
We're not saying be obsessed and you cannot do anything unless you're with her.
Yeah.
But be present. You need to establish that there's the presence of a man in her life.
Yes.
People need to see you guys together.
Yes.
People need to know, because let me tell you something. What presence does is that she herself becomes overwhelmed with every day that you guys are together.
Yes.
And then when she's talking randomly to anybody, your talk must come up.
Yes.
She must give an example that that day when I was with Kunle, so people are hearing, ah, there's a Kunle, there's something going on.
Yeah.
They're hearing it so often that everybody now knows that there's somebody that's in this person's life.
Yeah.
So it's important for you to always be present. You cannot take it for granted.
Yeah.
Like my husband said, the days are now evil.
Yeah.
Even when somebody is married, somebody can decide to come and say, it's a challenge to me. Let's go.
Yes.
So you must establish your presence. Mm. You must be there. You cast the dating shadow because you're actually dating. Cast yourself on her.
Yes.
It must be seen evidently because every day you guys are together, you are building memories.
Yes.
So every day, once she's talking, out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaketh.
Yes.
Because you have placed yourself in the position where you are always with her. It's as if nothing in her life goes on without you being in the picture.
Yes.
So everybody now knows that there's somebody there. This guy is there. So be present. Be a present guy. Don't be absent. Don't give excuses because work and this and that. The other people that have the time to take her. So create the time to be there for her.
That's true. And you know, adding to what she has said, you know, be there enough.
Yes.
Like, can I emphasize, you know, and what that presence will do for you, or that things presence will do for you is, one, it would help you detect when something is wrong in your relationship quicker. You would know when she's distracted quicker.
Yes.
The worst part is this: if you're not present, you may not be a shoulder to lean on. And if you're not, if someone else is a shoulder to lean on, if she leans on too long, she might get stuck on with the person.
Yes.
Before you know, another guy or is coming up in your conversations too often.
Yes. Yes, you're not even paying her.
Somebody else is the shoulder to lean on. And before you know, something's going wrong. You know, so this is for every serious guy.
Be present.
And we're still just talking about establishing territory. So that's why we said
these are ways to establish your territory.
Yeah. This video is going to be long, you know. So another thing you can do is to make impressions. Make an effort to make impressions. Let me explain what I mean. You see, most times when people gist you, when you're at your friends, your relatives, what people talk about are moments that stuck in your heart. Moments that meant a lot to you, either good or bad. Either you were hurt, or you had so much fun or pleasure, or you were entertained, or you enjoyed the thing. You know, so what I'm saying is that every opportunity to be, how would I put it now, to have that heroic complex, do not pass it out. Every opportunity you have to, show yourself mighty.
Oh my God. Make sure you do it.
Make sure you do it. Don't throw it to someone else. Let one guy not be the one saving her, helping her, being there. As much as you can, that hero complex, make an impression. Like, have those moments in her life where, when she remember, I say, Kai, you were there. You were there. Do you know, there are sometimes somebody will fight with you, but they'll be like, Kai, it's unfair if I even do this thing to this person. I remember.
Yes.
You know, I was just with my friend yesterday, and he was telling me about one of his relatives that married a lady, and the family kept saying, the lady's ugly. And the guy said, what? That he doesn't care what people think. That while they were dating, one time, he was arrested in US, and she... He was arrested because he didn't have his license and F1. Some other traffic rules he broke. It was her that rose $1,000 to come and pay for his
bill.
$1,000 to come and pay for his as a student.
What?
She hustled the $1,000 while he was in jail to come and bail him out.
Wow.
See? Till today, that's his reason for remaining with the woman, even though people have things to say. Like, that's almost like 10, 15 years ago. It made an impression on his heart.
That's true.
That he said, man, this one, there's no way.
Exactly.
You know, so making an impression, and as many as you can, do that.
Take a cue from Korean movies.
Yeah.
She's about to cross the road, and then the guy just turns her.
He's not the same. I don't watch shorts.
What? We are one.
Oh, they listen to. The only things I do in my life is listen to.
Shane knows God is watching this video.
Okay, sorry. let's just
Yes. Alright, so another way to mark your territory is to use social media. We're in the social media age, for heaven's sake. Yes. Look, no matter how private you are. One picture, You must not say, oh my baby, or say something. Just post a ray of sunshine.
Mm.
Oh, something like that. Oh, that.
Mm.
Please. So, I have a friend. He's extremely private. But at least in a month, he'll post like twice. I've monitored him. He'll post like two times. Picture of the girl he's dating and then picture of both of them together. Sometimes he just puts flowers or he puts smiley, love or whatever. It, at least you are doing something.
Yeah.
Use social media. Because guess what? Someone that you don't even think, oh, it's your friend like that, you guys are not G's like that, is seeing your post. And one day he might just see your girl with another guy. He will just start acting as watchdog for you. See you.
This one is
there's taking. This exactly. This one is taking. Do you understand?
Mm.
So it's important for you to make use of social media,
yeah.
Not even just for posting, but you can do sweet things because of the social media age. My God, take a cue from Pastor Tiza. You can check his page. Let's continue. Are you feeling yourself?
As in this is now.
Humility is our only problem in this house.
Yes, so yeah, you know, as much as you can try that. So the next point now, we've left establishing territory. Now, the next way you can maintain everything, one of the things a guy needs to know to maintain a good relationship, or you know, every serious guy needs to know, is this: you need to reaffirm a position. You need to reaffirm her position. I mean, can I tell you a big secret? A lot of guys that are players are successful players because they do this. They tell every girl they play that she's the only one.
Ah, man of God, preach. That's very right.
They tell her, see, you are the only one. As in, there's none like you. So the lady, even if there's evidence, whether circumstantial or through evidence,
situational,
or any situation, every kind of evidence presented to her, that guy is assuring her that she's the only one. Mm-hmm. And guess what? Most times they will be wrong with it. I have to say this: no matter how advanced we get in society, most, I won't generalize with all, but I'll say most. And when I say most, I mean 95% of women are still moved by what they hear.
Yeah, very true.
And 95% of men are moved by what they see.
Yeah.
It's just a genetic order. As you can't change it, it happens. Most of the times, women are moved by what they hear.
Mm.
And men are moved by what they see. I mean, for the other, for the relationship with the other gender.
Yeah.
What they hear and what they see.
Yeah.
So, I'll go straight to it. One of the ways you can reaffirm a position is by what you see.
Fine.
Just reaffirm. As in, sometimes tell her, I know you're not a player, but you're not insecure. You're just out of the blues. See, baby, you're the one for me.
Baby.
You're the one for me.
Mm.
I love you.
I know.
I can never.
I know God is watching me now.
Yeah.
So God's hearing me.
So that's an example. Like, be serious. Not you know, we're joking. We're not joking, you know,
yes.
But be serious with it. Like, out of the blues, you guys can be watching. Maybe if your girl is someone that plays PS with you or watches football with you, you just pause, or watching a movie, something, say just pause and tell her. Those things will ring.
Ah, oh my show.
It will ring. Anyways. It will ring, you know. So, do your best to tell her about her position. Okay. So, yes. Then another thing you can do is, let me. What do you think about? Okay. No. Let me ask you. What do you think? I know for sure. Making discussions and putting her in the future.
Hey. Oh my God.
Making discussions around their future and putting her. Let me tell you something. Most times, when a woman can see a future with you, it doesn't matter what anyone says.
Her commitment level,
skyrocket. Doesn't see. One of the things guys don't know is that if a woman cannot see a future with you, it doesn't matter what you are saying.
Yeah, it's true.
It doesn't matter what you are saying.
Yeah.
But once she can see a future with you, it doesn't matter what anybody is saying.
Mm.
It will continue with you.
Yeah.
So, what am I saying in essence? What you can do is this. You can from time to time when you're making discussions. And it's not because you are scamming or lying. It is the truth. Because as we said, it's for serious guys.
Yeah.
So you want your relationship to thrive. Yeah. You know, even onto the marriage. Guy, what you can do is when you're making conversations. Example, when we build our house in the future.
Yes, sir.
What color do you think you should? Do you mix colors? What kind of colors? See, so already, yes, there's this house you're living in already. She knows you as a guy that is established. But she can see you put her in your future.
Yeah.
You are affirming her place that she's the one that you want to end up with.
Yeah. How many children should we have?
Exactly. Mm-hmm. Conversations like that give you the assurance that, or gives her rather,
yeah,
the assurance that, man, there is a future for me.
Simple
with this guy.
Things. Where should we travel to on holidays?
It's working.
Wisdom is my only problem.
It's part of the contact of the anointing. Receive.
So, let me give you one wala. Another way to reaffirm her position. For example, now we're talking about this yesterday.
Mm-hmm.
You go to a place and you notice that fine babes are here.
Yes.
And you know she's already feeling, oh, wow, why do you see fine girls?
Yeah.
Hold her hand.
Mm.
Let people know that you guys are together.
Yes.
Hold her hand.
Yes.
Or you can just put your hand on her body or something.
Yes.
While you're talking, hold her hand, you know, move along with her. Mm. When you meet someone, oh hi, this is my girlfriend,
yes,
this is this person, and then you also introduce the person.
Yes.
Making everybody know that you have someone, you,
yes,
are reaffirming her position.
That's true.
So she now eases up, she's like, okay,
No tension.
Exactly. Mm. So that's very, very important.
Yes.
Alright, so another thing that a serious guy should do, in the name of God, please take care of yourself.
Yeah.
It's not a sin. I told my husband yesterday, it's not only homosexuals that rub powder. If your face is oily, dab a little. Just look good. Use body spray. Use perfume. It must not be expensive. Look, even if you don't have a car, you are going to a place with keke and you guys are going out, you can at least afford to charter one.
Yeah.
Just charter to where you are going to. So that it's just both of you. Get... if you're in Lagos, you know these markets, go and buy 200 naira shirts, starch it, let the thing get, you know, parachute. That's what CU boys call it. My CU boys, look good. Don't make her to defend you every day. Everybody is insulting you and she say no, it's not like that, he has a good heart, he's very kind. Make people understand that you are a good person too. Look good. Take care of yourself. Get nice haircuts. Brush your hair. I understand that your hair always coils, but at least I know some people that have small hair brushes in their pockets or combs. Just arrange it. Look neat. Just put lip balm. Let your lips not be chapped.
Right.
Polish your shoe. Just look neat. Iron your trouser. Let it have sharp gaiters in front. It's not hard to do. It's not hard. You know, I'm telling you, it's so much work for a lady to be defending you every day. Hey, you are looking so tattered, you are looking dirty. Her family is against you because of how you look. Her friends are insulting you because of how you look. And she's defending you every day.
Mm.
She will get tired of defending you.
Yeah.
So please, make a defense for yourself by looking good.
Yeah.
Look presentable. For heaven's sake, it's not really hard.
Yeah.
Those small things, if you look, powder small. Chapettes, is that what they call it? Yes.
Mm.
Chapettes or lip balm, whatever. Brush your hair, iron your clothes, starch it. Look. Have you heard all that packaging? You can package yourself so well. People will think you cost $1 billion because of just how you package yourself. So it's very important. Very, very important.
Yeah. As much as, and then, you know, there's some. So just use oil.
If you don't have beard, condition it.
Yeah.
So that when you come close to her, it's not like, is there an iron sponge here? Do you understand?
Yeah, they just make the effort. Even if you cannot afford it, which I know it's not, you know, as you said, recommended, you know, you can buy what's affordable and make it look good. But don't be in a position where they have to defend you all the time. See, adding to take care of yourself. Guys, please. If you wear your boxers more than twice, it's a problem. Mm. It will smell.
Mm.
Your singlet. See, you may not, you know that thing where you like, and say, ah, it's not smelling. Guy, it's smelling. You don't just smell. It's smelling. Oh, let me tell you what happens. If I heard this story once, Fela Duretore told this story once. And it's funny. He said those days when he was at Blue State. I can't say. But he said, you know, when young students will come for counseling, maybe they left the office. That when people come around, they're like, ah, Fela. You know, he spoke in Yoruba, I can't say, but it's not like, what's going on? What's going on? And why is this place? You know, but the person that came probably just did the same thing. That's not my boy again. And they came and sat down there. So you left your presence when you left. So when people came, they knew you were here. You know, so nowadays they are, what they call it now? They are things you can use around. You know, just take care of yourself. Make an effort, a conscious effort.
And please, there's one other thing. At least if you are going to visit your guest, lick sweets. Just let the mouth just be clear. You understand? If you sleep before you go out, visit her, your mouth has been closed. It's going to be warm. Brush. If you cannot afford to buy 10, say, look, center fresh. Just do it. Let me tell you something. It's not just because you want to impress her, but it's very, very important for even how you present yourself to her. Let me tell you something. For we that have been married for years, many times we have center fresh. We take Tom Tom. Most of the time, you just pop it in the mouth, just so that your mouth is fresh. By the time you even talk, the man of God will hear the voice of the Lord. You'll just be like, just give her 50k. Just give her 50k.
Say no, that's the devil. We bind. We cast out.
So,
we reject. but yeah, that's true. That's
very important. Cook okay, this one nice for women.
That's very interesting. But then, you know, as a guy too, you know, if you're serious about relationship, you need to pay attention to execute. What do I mean? Giving your time is okay, but listening as well, paying attention to details. Let me tell you what paying attention will do for you. I need to emphasize this point more. What paying attention to for you, one is this: you can discern when something is bothering. Sometimes you can't discern quick enough, and then she goes to lean on someone else, as we said in the first point.
That's true.
Number two is that you can discern if there is a predator around. If there's a predator around, somebody is coming to try to chop your head.
Yeah.
You know, sometimes maybe one guy's name is coming up too often. You didn't, when I heard his name before, suddenly you are hearing his name. You are not noticing that one of your guys is coming to visit your babe too much. You are not even paying attention.
He's asking you about the girl all the time.
You know, you are not paying attention. So you are careless with it. And one day you say, what's going on here? And then, you know, it just, and then once a woman moves on, guy, that's all. It takes them time, but once they do it, you are gone.
Yeah.
So you can discern quickly when your attention is taken away. One of the strongest things again is that you can discern when you are doing the wrong thing. You know, some people just conclude that every woman is the same. They all come from the same mold. So you just think that everybody, listen, even though we may like the same things, like all men may like certain things and all women may like certain things, we're still different in our desires and our tastes. So you may think that, let me give you a practical example. You may think that, this lady may want her family or if her friends to be involved in a particular thing, it will make her feel happy. And probably she doesn't enjoy those kinds of things with friends and family around. Then you now make the mistake to bring them. You rather spoil things and make things better. That's just a simple example, but it reveals some of the things that happen in other areas. You might just generalize and think, if you don't pay attention. Let's say recently I was able to. Okay, let me use this example of when I proposed to my wife. The setting of the proposal was her family, because she had talked about her family often and all that. Even our anniversary, we just celebrated recently. One of the things that helped me was because I was paying attention to the things she was saying.
It's true.
She was listening, the places she was visiting.
Yeah.
At check, you know. And I saw that, listen. In fact, the dress that I bought for her, I saw her look at it one time. But she said she pushed it. She was like, I want to buy this dress. But anyways, later when I do, when I'm ready, I'll buy it. Then yes. She bought some other dresses. I said, this one she can't buy it now. So I was like, okay, this will be a perfect surprise. And then see, you can wow.
Yes, you can. Pay attention, baby. I'm sorry to cut you, but let me tell you something. The way I proposed, my proposal was it our proposal? Well, it was me they proposed to. My proposal was very different from her anniversary was. Though I'm a very family oriented person. So for our proposal, I always spoke about, I wanted my family and my friends to be there. But recently, I started telling him that, my next birthday, you know, our anniversary, I wanted to just be both of us. I wanted it to be intimate. And that's what he did.
Yeah.
So you cannot say, because she's a family person and he walked during the proposal, then he's going to walk now.
Yeah.
People change too. People's desires also change. That's why it's important for you to pay attention.
Yes, that's true. So that's true. And then, of course, the final most important thing to do. Amongst the things. These are not the only things to do, but we just listed these five so that it can help you.
Mm-hmm.
If you get these five right, nothing can go wrong.
Yeah.
Every guy that's a serious relationship, he must at least have his splash of
romance. Nice.
Very, very important. Very, 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 very important. In the age we are now, listen, influence and pressure is more than before.
Yes.
See, you may think that your babe does not want this thing because she's not asking.
Okay.
But try it. Just try it and see what will happen. Things will change. Things will change.
That's true.
Things will change.
That's true.
And if you're married too, we'll do a married edition of this. If things will change for you, listen, romance isn't something you go out of your pocket or way to do. It's not something, it's just to think. Just to think. There are simple ways. Listen, we are biological human beings. We are humans and we all have that tendency or desire to be needed, to be shown concern, that we are loved. It's a biological thing. Animals do it too.
Yeah.
So it's an animalistic thing, like we all. So we are higher animals, they are lower. All of us desire the same thing.
Yeah.
You get it? So as little, let's give you a few tips. As little as having pet names
goes a long way.
A long way. Mama bear.
Papa bear.
As little as having pet names goes a long way.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, what is there? I'm calling her
mommy.
Or
especially when you're married, sorry.
Or you call her name by her name just every time. You know, Faith.
I think the only time my husband calls me my name is when we're in church and he's like, Pastor Faith.
Yes.
He so never that, calls my name.
You know, so everybody
and I never call his name,
with the idea of calling her that. But if not, you know, pet names. Somebody say, how can you say it? People call themselves babies. It's a lie. So everybody, some people are not.
There's one of my husband's nickname. I nicknamed it. And our son even calls him the name.
Yes.
You just stand and shout.
So this happened. Bis. I'm like, who's bis? I'm your father. Are you kidding me? He said, bis.
George recently, I was talking to my dad. I went to see him. And we're talking. So I asked, reflex. And I said, babe. Then we kept quiet. Then I continued talking. And I said, okay, sorry, daddy. My dad was like, I know, just move on like I moved on. You don't need to explain.
You know, as little as having signature gestures. See, I kiss her on her forehead every day. Or, you know, I kiss her on her hand.
Yes, just hold the
just
hand.
Just hold the hand and look. You know, this guy, she knows that this is what my guy does all the time. All the time. Like, you just out of the blue just hold me and then pet me on my
body. Even tickles, like you just somebody just stand there, just go and tickle.
Simple romance. Listen, or you don't need to, even if you don't call every day, or even if you call every day, at least send a text.
Yeah,
as a romance, it is not outdated to send it. Listen, when you send those things, when you're not around, they'll go out from the text.
Yeah.
I'll be reading it again.
Yeah.
It happens.
Yeah. When we did, my son wrote me a beautiful letter, like, letters and all of that. Let me tell you, there was a time that I was even sick. My husband sends stuff, Jumia, pepper soup, fruits, food, blah, blah, blah. Ah, I said, God, I don't have my.
I need to meet when I'm not feeling fine. Sometimes I just want to not be feeling
fine. There was one time, I knew he was where. I'm like, he doesn't want to get where, say he's well, so that I'll continue petting him. You know, just nice things. Do you know, you can even invite her to your house, make an effort, even if you cook indomie,
yes,
and egg.
And see, you need
small things.
Small things. As in, learn how to, she knows you don't know how to cook.
Exactly.
So make the effort. Even if she knows you can cook, make the effort. Let it be extra.
Ah, God.
Or you can send stuff to her office. Don't wait for her birthday.
Exactly.
See, that one bar is the best strategy. Let me explain.
Every
once you go to the office, once you don't even need to go. It has to be, it can be a delivery. It doesn't matter her position in the office,
yes,
guys. It doesn't matter. Can I tell you why? The office she works or wherever she works. See, I can bet you there's one idiot that is following her up and down. Even if he's not saying it.
Yes, he's eyeing her.
He's eyeing her. He's thinking of it. If, even though he knows he's married. Why I say he's an idiot? Because he knows she's married.
Yes.
But he's still not nurturing there again, not seeing it, and making plans towards it. Guy, if you make a statement there, everything, all voices will
the
show
other her. Workers will start helping you monitor her.
Monitor.
And chase that person away.
Yeah, help you. Let me not say monitor, but guide her.
Guard her.
Because when you do that, in fact, you might even clear doubts. Because people, the one guy that is trying to form that is Mr. Romantic in the office, when you show yourself like this, you say, that's also establishing territory.
That's true.
When you show yourself, you know, and then she'll feel happy, she'll feel sad. I don't know, but I know some people do not like those public things. So investigate. Yeah. Investigate if she won't mind, you know. Mm-hmm. You must ask her directly, but, you know, just about instances like that. Mm-hmm. That's how to find out. You don't need to say, what if I
want to do.
You say, there was this guy. Or find a video. There are plenty of videos like that. Say, they sent something to lady in the office. Her reaction will tell you if that kind of thing will move her or not. If she says, no, that's
nice.
Rubbish. Please don't try, bro. Please don't try. Some people don't like this kind of thing. So I have to put that disclaimer.
Yes.
So, but make an effort. Make an effort.
Splash it.
As in, at least.
Just even if you just sprinkle.
Even if you blow breeze on
one drop
of romance, blow it.
It's so
important. Don't think that even if you can't afford it. Let me say this for guys that, you know, you are dating, but you are still trusting God, right? Faith. Listen, sometimes you can call in favors. You can call in favors. Abba, there must be somebody for you to be able to watch this video now.
That means
you know somebody, one or two people that can, you can call one or two favors from.
Yeah.
Even if, is it to go and ask for car or help, ask for them to help you do something? Or, I mean, simple gestures, just simple ways to show romance. You can go, Abba. Even if it's to find the most sophisticated, not sophisticated as expensive, but an upgrade mama food that you will go to, and the food is sweet, and so you go there.
Mm-hmm.
But to have an experience, as it
makes sense. Even if your voice is bad, you know that if you attend singing for her, she will always remember nothing. Small things, just do one dance step. If you are not a dancer like my husband, you know, just do something. God, this life is not that serious. It's not hard. You can enjoy. Everybody wants to be intimate with somebody.
Yeah.
And romance facilitates intimacy.
That's true.
So just try a splash, a sprinkle, a dash.
Yeah, of romance, and everything will be fine.
Yeah.
So thank you guys for watching.
I'm sure you enjoyed watching this video.
Yes.
So subscribe.
Yes.
Give a thumbs up.
Yeah.
Click on the notification bell. You can share this video.
Yeah.
Leave a comment.
Yeah.
And
like it.
Like it. Everything.
Everything.
Make sure you subscribe. Make sure you subscribe.
Make sure you subscribe. Please.
Thank you. He now does that all the time.
Subscribe. What are you looking at?
Ooh!
Subscribe.
Thank you for watching this video.
Thank you so much for watching. Thank you.